think I'm in cardiac arrest, darling.
All right, I think I am. Okay, all right, take it
easy. No, I mean, really, I knew in my heart, I knew that he was alive, but what a way to get the truth. I mean, what is the matter with that woman, anyway? Why is she so secretive about her sources? Why?
I think Margo has something to do with all this stuff. What a story. It doesn't say where he was,
no,
how he escaped, where he is now.
Nothing.
Like
that. That's the way the Argus... Well, I mean, for heaven's sake, there's no information that... You know, if Earl really has something to do with the story, it could be the CIA. Could, oh, my God.
Why didn't you get on the telephone and give Montega a call?
I will. Right now? I'm just connecting my thoughts. I got to get that girl back home. She's got to be home with the baby. With the...
Exactly.
Hi-ya.
Well, darling, what about your appointment with this guy Andersen?
Oh, the hell with him. Heaven's sake, this is a holiday. Darling.
Yes?
Darling,
oh, no. Yes. Good news. It's good news.
It's wonderful news. And he's coming home, and Sierra's going to have her husband, and the grandchild is going to have his father, and I'm going to have a heart attack.
Oh, you're going to be fine.
Darling, oh. Good morning.
I'll be with you in a second.
Oh, I tried to call you earlier, but Ambrose gave me his okay. What are you doing here?
I'm looking at all the pledges and grants that Walsh Enterprises made to Memorial Hospital. Miss Snyder's in charge of it on this end, so I thought I'd get my facts straight from the horse's mouth.
I beg your pardon. I don't understand why you think you need this information right now.
I'll explain it to you when we get back to the office, unless...
Just a minute, Mr. Anderson. I'm not going back to the office today. And you don't have to answer any of my questions today. Because I'm not working today.
Why not?
Because I'm very excited and happy about something. Isn't it wonderful that
we heard
about Craig?
I know.
But he's alive. Craig is alive and he's coming home to Oakdale. Look, why don't you get on the phone before I do something really idiotic and cry?
You remember, sis. But I love you.
And you remember. Montega, and then that you hired a private plane to fly you there?
I couldn't call you sooner.
But then we heard that the pilot took off without you.
Almost. I managed to flag him down as he was taxiing down the runway.
Is everyone all right?
Your grandson's fine. He's right here in my lap. It's not the happy trip home we expected.
Craig, what's wrong?
Sierra isn't with us.
All we know is that Sierra's friend told Craig that Sierra was marched into a public square and executed.
I can't believe it. I know Craig was so happy last week.
It's a miracle even found Bryant.
Sierra had hit him near her father's estate. When she knew her own life was going to be in danger.
Casey, Craig wanted you to go over to Duplex, maybe get some things of Bryant's, you know, when he comes here.
Where are the keys?
They're in the desk over there. Now I have to go over to Lucinda. Craig wanted me to tell her. Mr. Montgomery, would it be all right if your son stayed in up front with the captain and crew? I'm afraid they've fallen in love with him.
Yeah, it's no trouble.
Oh, it's no trouble. You and your wife must be very proud of him.
We are.
Thank you.
My dearest husband, so little time to write this and so many things to say. And looking back, it seems we've always had that problem. Bryant and I have been so looking forward to the happiness of seeing you again. Then came news of fighting in the Capitol. I have no idea how serious the situation is. I do not fear for myself, but our son, Bryant, just a baby with his whole life ahead of him. I will do everything necessary to protect him if the awful rumors prove true. Dear, dear Craig, I hope you never read this letter. I hope the fighting ends before I finish writing it. But if it doesn't, and if things should turn out differently, I want you to know I have no regrets about returning to Montega. This is where my roots are, and in a strange way, the roots of our love are here too. Having those memories made it easier to wait for you. And you know, spending all these months apart has only made me realize how strong the bond is between us. I always knew you were alive, my darling. I knew it. How can we ever explain to anyone else the closeness that's always been there between us? From the first day we fell in love. In spite of all the time we've been forced to live apart, the times we've been together have given me a happiness few women ever know. I thank you for that, Craig. And for Bryant. If something should happen to me, please do not waste your time in grief. Think only of our son, for he is truly a bond that can never be broken. I am yours always. I love you. Sierra.
Ignore.